Hi. So this is where we get to the end of the garment. We've done all our knitting and we're ready to put it together. So you want to make sure, obviously, that you've got all your pieces, that you have them nice and ready to do it, okay? So you haven't got all kinds of things that you still have to do. All your pieces together. You have a needle in your kit. So this is your wool needle. It has a blunt end because you don't want to be sticking it into yourself. And just taking a piece of wool. Now I'm using a contrasting colour here just so that you can see what we're doing to make it just clearer. But obviously you're not going to knit up your lovely white jumper with pink wool. What you can do is when you start your knitting, when you're casting on, you can leave a tail of wool, maybe two or three times as long as this, as long as you're not going to get all tangled up. But that's what I usually do. Then I thread onto that, which is it's very simple. You just thread the needle onto that and then I sew away, and then I don't have the risk of it coming undone at this end. But just for the sake of this, I'm going to show you with a contrasting wool just so that you can see what we're doing. So we'll just do a couple of stitches in the one place just to firm it up, just to make sure that it doesn't come undone. Okay, and then we put the two edges right at the very edge. And by the way, don't press the garment. Because you'll see in your instructions it says don't press them, and that's just because this is really lovely, pure, new, absolutely perfect wool, and it won't like being pressed. It'll shrivel up on you and it'll go all horrible. So don't press it. It doesn't need to be pressed. So just flatten it out with your hands and hold the two edges absolutely edge to edge like that. You've got your wool firmly attached, and then you're going to go just find a loop there and go there, and then you're just going to go along a little bit, tiny little bit, to the next row down. You'll find you can easily make out which row is which from the side, and then you do the same on this side. So you're actually just going to loop it like that, it's edge to edge like that, and then we go back this side and we find a little loop. Obviously we're not going to go right back into the knitting because that would look funny. So we go onto the edge, get in like that, and we just have it put together neatly like that, so that next little piece of wool there, so that you can't really see the stitching when you're finished, and you have a kind of a blind seam. It just looks like it's actually knitted together. You just keep going all the way down to the end of the garment, so the end of the seam rather, and just make sure you finish it off so that it's not going to come undone. And there you are. Now, some people like to sew with the right sides together, some people with the wrong sides together, but basically I think what's best is if you have the right sides facing up, because then you can see what it's going to look like when you finish. You can make sure it's really neat. But you could do it the other way if you like and have sew it with the wrong sides up. It's whatever you think yourself is going to look better. And I think it's a good idea if you try it out both ways and see which works best for you, because everybody has their own way of doing it. But it's very, very simple, and people are often really put off at the thought of having to sew the thing together, but it's the finishing touches which make the difference. So it's worth spending a little bit of time and patience to sew it up neatly. Thanks.